Some headlines on housing, I'll repeat them for you. The inventory of homes for sale at an all-time low. And second, Wall Street getting into the home flipping business, like KKR, Goldman Sachs. They're issuing loans to people to buy, renovate, and then resell homes. Samantha DeBianchi from DeBianchi Real Estate is with us. Samantha, you're a broker. I mean, they're invading your turf. You've got to be worried about this.
I mean, not so much. As far as home flippers as a whole, home flippers made up 6% of homes sold in 2017. That's up from 2016, where it was 5.7%. We have no inventory right now. I mean, according to the National Association of Realtors, there's only 900,000 new homes that are predicted to come on the market in 2018. We need 1.3 million homes just to meet normal population growth. So whether it's a house flipper, whether it's Wall Street firms buying and writing these loans for flippers, nobody's going to take business from me. Everyone's going to work with me. I'm not concerned at all.
But the big problem, surely, not necessarily for the real estate industry, for the brokers, the big problem is for buyers, because when Wall Street money arrives for used homes, you know, existing homes, that pushes up the price. And there's already a very, very low inventory of homes for sale in the first place. Newcomers to the market can have a very hard time getting in.
Right. Well, again, like we said in previous weeks, you know, home buyers, they're a lot more savvy. They're a lot more educated. And I will say home prices are increasing. The National Association of Realtors has said that home prices are expected to increase by 4% over the next 12 months. And some states like Washington and Colorado, they might even see price gains of 8%, which is nuts. But with that said, buyers aren't really all that concerned because they will wait. They will rent. They will sit on the sideline until they find something they want, or they'll also buy something that might need some renovations. They might say, well, this is kind of a fixer-upper. They'll buy something that's maybe less expensive, carry that mortgage. Once they save up some extra money and some time and some convenience, they'll also put that money into their home. They'll build that equity. They'll add some upgrades. And then they, too, might also become a house flipper one day.
I think you're being awfully relaxed about this, because if I'm a first-time buyer or I'm somebody in my 30s or a second-time buyer, I don't want to be waiting around as interest rates rise and prices rise. I don't want to be sitting around waiting. I want in now. And your industry is making it difficult for me.
You bought a house at a 12% interest rate. Rates right now for a 30-year fix is at about 4.5%. So that is, there's no comparison. It is still a great time to buy. If you can find the right house and if you have the money, it is definitely a great time to buy. And if you don't find that home, it's okay to rent until you do find that, because we all say there's no inventory, there's nothing out there. And so many people, whether it's house flippers or, you know, new construction, we're trying to get that out as quickly as possible. So I definitely don't think there's any issue here, and buyers don't have to worry. They just need to be patient.
Well, that's interesting. Don't need to worry. There's no issue here. They just have to be patient. Wow.
Patience is a virtue.
We have some opposition to what you're saying in our studio right now, but I don't have time to get into it. But Samantha, you talk your book very well. We'll see you again shortly. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.